Alrighty, welcome to round two. We lost the die roll. We are here on the draw, but this hand's pretty sweet on the draw. We have a Force Will that can pitch to itself. We have a Baleful Strix that can recoup some of that card disadvantage. And then we also have a spot removal and acceleration. The only thing this hand is really missing is some form of way to win the game, like a Planeswalker. The Sternwell Goblin Guide's interesting. I think we let it resolve, because otherwise this Go for the Throat isn't doing much. So it's going to hit us for 4 here. I think that's fine. The Force of Will is probably going to get better value than that. It's real unfortunate that we have to play against Burn in back-to-back rounds. I'll probably record some bonus rounds after this, just to make sure that you guys get your value in. Phyrexian Revoker. Oh, this isn't a typical Burn deck. He saw the Thopter Foundry, and the Gopher Throat isn't going to be able to kill Revoker, so I think I have to force that. I'm going to force pitching Baleful Strix. Interesting. I actually like that a lot. Turn 1 Goblin Guide, turn 2 for Phyrexian Revoker. Phyrexian Revoker actually seems really good out of that deck. Answers a few of the problems the deck has. So we're just going to ship the turn back, get a Goblin Guide trigger before we kill it with Go for the Throat. Another Thopter Foundry. The good news about that is that we can pitch the Thopter Foundry that's in our hand without any remorse. Molten Rain. How much do I care about that? A lot, actually. I don't want to have to rely on Ancient Tomb for mana. In fact, I don't think we even run it out. Just because of Price of Progress. The nice thing about playing it is if we drew a City of Traitors, we could play Karn the turn after. We're going to at least need a fourth mana source if we draw Planeswalkers, so I think I'm fine playing the Underground Sea. Dang, nabbit. I'm just deciding if I want to scoop up the Talisman of Dominance or just the Thopter Foundry. I think I'm going to do both. Yeah. Because he would have revoked whichever one of them I didn't sacrifice. I just decided to make one. And now I have two blockers for his revoker, so he can't really attack into them. He probably just names Thopter Foundry anyway, yeah. Doesn't know that there's only two Thopter Foundries left in the deck. I don't hate attacking for one here. Because we do the Sword of the Meek. Sure, that is just fine. Because the chain could have gone to my face to also deal with 3. Again, we're at 14, he's at 19. There's no reason to get in a race situation. I can use his burn spells. Tezzeret. You wonderful card, you. I don't know if we take that up or not. I think we make a 5/5. It gives him the option to just kill it. And then just leaves us with a 5/5. I think that's fine. I think we do this pass, hope that he uses a burn on the Tezzeret. If he doesn't, then we get to make another one and like go tenu, or decide to tick up or whatever it is. Taking up Tezzeret wouldn't have been the worst. Would have given us a chance to find. I guess Thought for Foundry would have been a bad hit. Chalice, I guess. Hard to say. He would have just threatened an ultimate. He would have just hit it. And then I would have still had a Tezzeret at 2, but I wouldn't have had a 5-5 in play. Yeah, he just decides to bolt it. Deciding whether I want to attack or not. I don't think so. I think next turn, Polluted Delta is going to fetch me a basic, and then I'm going to go down to 9 for this Ancient Tomb, so that I can Karn, tick up, and exile a card in his hand. Maybe that's wrong. I think it's better than attacking and trying to race, though. Okay, he clearly values his guy pretty highly. I can almost wait a turn and see if I can get away with playing the Karn without taking any damage. I think it's better to get it into play sooner. That's tricky as to whether we should make him exile a card from his hand or hit a creature that he has in play. Remember, the price of progress would deal us 6 here, which would be very close to dead. So exiling one of his guys, I don't know what that does, actually. I'm going to do this. Didn't really like either option. Chrome Mox, that's interesting. Now on this turn, he should be pretty aware that we're probably just going to tick up Karn again. So if he has a card in his hand that he can play, he probably will. I guess Molten Rain and Price of Progress don't really go well together. It's possible he's not even playing the card. It's also not likely. See what he does here. Fire Blast. Full mana, sure. I think this is correct. We don't want him to be able to draw something that deals 3 damage, like a bolt off the top, and just kill us. Just like suicide his guys into it. So, there's no reason not to damnation here. I'm holding on to the island in our hand in case we need to tick up Karn to exile something, to potentially restart the game. I'm considering restarting the game with Karn. And in fact, if he played a burn spell here, I would just restart. What the heck? White or blue instant or sorcery spell. Mindsparker deals 2 damage to that player. I guess that's not a bad card in Legacy, especially since he's more creature-based burn. That's really interesting. His deck is neat. I guess I just exile that with the Karn instead of restarting the game. This gives me something to restart the game with. Saving Spirit Guide, alright. I'll exile that too. I'll feel silly if he just top decks a Price of Progress and kills me, but it was hard to just restart the game for no value except for a random Chromebox in play. Jeez, down to one. Alright. Let's hope he doesn't draw. He has two draws towards any burn spell or a haste creature, and that seems to be what his deck consists of. Force of Will. Okay, that's a really good draw, actually. We have to exile Mishra's Factory so we don't die to it. Little awkward. So our best draw here is probably another Force of Will. There's for knowledge. I'm just going to fire this off. See if I find something sweet. Tezzeret. That's a good one. I think the Tezzeret just goes for the win. There's no reason not to. No reason not to play our City of Traders here. I guess Tezzeret could uptick to try and find a chalice. So there's three chalices in the deck, and we're looking at five cards. We probably have like a 50% chance of hitting Chalice of the Void. But if we just animate and hit, I think a Tezzeret Ultimate is really pretty much the same thing as winning the game from here. So yeah, I'm going to do the Tezzeret uptick thing. We did not hit. That's highly unfortunate. Okay. So now he's got one turn to just kill us. Pretty long tank. I respect the slow roll if that's what's happening. Mishra's Factory. Ding. And we drew another artifact. Awesome. And that should be game. We could have won by now if we had just animated a guy with Tezzeret and started attacking, but like I said, this way we had a chance of hitting a chalice, and Tezzeret ultimating should be the same thing as just ending the game anyway, so that's why I did this line. I'm pretty sure it was correct. Eventually he has to draw a brick, yeah. We get to play a chalice. I think we just run it out for one. And I should really be putting counters on this Ratchet Bomb before I forget. Like if he plays a Phyrexian Revoker or something, we don't want him to just be able to shut off our Karn. Yeah. Restart the game. Okay. He just conceded. As opposed to me restarting with a pile of dudes and manlands and stuff. So since he's more creature-based, I guess go for the throat doesn't really help. Almost seems like he's playing Blood Moon, which isn't actually a card against us since we have so much artifact mana. I mean, it's kind of a card, but it's kind of not at the same time. Think Damnation's really good against him. I'm not sure if Go for the Throat's worth two copies. I'm happy with the one for sure. I get the sense that he's going to be bringing in Rebs for me. For Tezzerets and Jaces and Thopter Foundries. I kind of want Duress, I kind of don't. I don't know. Vendilion Click seems similarly. Well, pretty good. Actually, I like Ratchet Bomb a lot against him. What do I not like? I guess Karn, even though Karn won me that game. I don't think I really have room for this stuff. Good shape of Thirst, I guess. Something like that. Like at least these can trade with these guys. I think this is fine. He had an awful lot of burn, but hopefully I'm gonna be able to shut that out with a Chalice of the Void or something.